Hello, all my beautiful Libran friends. You are, after all, ruled by Venus, the planet of beauty and love. And I have your September forecast right here in front of me, and I'm going to share it in a second. I just want to make sure that you are aware of my super blue moon special. This is a 6 month lunation forecast. By lunation, I mean new moons and full moons. This special ends the end last day of September. What I do is I take your birth chart and I track the path of the new moon when everything starts growing energetically, and the full moon 2 weeks later, where th when things come to a head. And I give you each position and an interpretation of that position, that lunation, for the new moon and the full moon. And that includes, of course, the October eclipses, which occur on new moons and a new moon and the full moon. It's a bargain because it's a wonderful adjunct to a regular forecast. And if you have your own forecast, then you know how helpful that is. And this gives you even more information. So if you're interested, just go to my website, maxinetaylor.com, and all the information is there. All right, let's talk about you. This is beautiful. First of all, let's just jump into the nitty-gritty, shall we? Jupiter, the planet of abundance and love and truth and money and all the good stuff. It is the greater benefic. It's going to go retrograde on September 5th. Now, it's been in the shadow since, for a while. When Jupiter, which is in your eighth house of other people's money, transformation, the psychic realm, all those things, rebirth, it is going to unearth secrets for you. So just ask spirit what you want to know, and you will be shown. But the if you're planning on any type of mutually beneficial joint money project, it may be held up a little bit because of the retrograde. I'm just saying. Okay, hang in there. Venus, the lesser benefic, is love and money and beauty. And between Jupiter and Venus, we've got all the good stuff handled. Venus has been retrograde. It will go direct on the third. It's in your 11th house of friends and group activities. And you just love being with your friends. Now, it's been retrograde, so you may not have, your relationships with friends may not have gelled the way you would have liked. Just making sure my cat is there on her back with her paws up. Okay, good. So now, when Venus goes direct, you will love being with your friends. You'll be able to connect with them, and the love will be mutual. Mercury, of course, everybody knows Mercury retrograde, right? Well, Mercury and Venus have both been retrograde at the same time, so it's a double whammy. It's going to go direct on September 15th. Yes. Hallelujah. And it's sitting with the sun in your 12th house of behind the scenes activities and preparations. Okay. This can be awesome because you are preparing. For what? For your birthday, because that's when everything starts coming alive. Okay. And I'm going to talk about that in a second. So when Mercury goes direct, now this is the 12th house is the spirit plane, and it's hard to see the spirit plane. It's hard to read the spirit plane, but it manifests as I want to be alone and meditate and do my thing privately. Mercury retrograde confuses your thinking. When it goes direct, you will have clarity of thought. And that sun in the 12th house says the center of your life is the spirit plane. It is preparation. All right. On the 23rd, the sun crosses your ascendant, your solar ascendant, and you say, here I am, world. Here I am. And you're going to be loving yourself and doing what you want, when you want, how you want, because you want. Why? Not just because the sun, the center of our universe, is in your first house of you, but because Mars, the red planet, that's what is number one for us. And it's in your first house, and your mantra is, out of my way. I'm doing it my way. And you know what? Do it your way. Don't squelch it. You will act more innovatively and more independently. You'll see. It is great. Now, we have a new moon on the 14th. And what this does is it reinforces your desire for solitude and privacy and working behind the scenes. I get it. And that's going to be with you for 2 weeks. Well, on the full moon, which is on the 29th, it's in 6 degrees of Aries, in your seventh house of partnership, relationships. What kind of relationships? Business, romance, one-on-one relationships, contracts. This brings relationships to a head to be resolved the way you want, because you're setting it up your way. And then the full moon says, well, you know, I can compromise a little bit. And then you achieve the Libra balance, which we all want. So there is your September forecast. I hope you love it. And I hope you'll join me again next month when, once again, we pick up where we left off. So till then, this is Maxine Taylor saying, may the stars shine brightly on you and yours. Bye for now.